The problem with political parties is that they are completely hypocritical when it comes to the issue of caste politics. They say one thing and do another, which is why, as I introduce the panel, I'd like to say I'm expanding this debate beyond the immediate scope of just the Allahabad High Court order, because the Allahabad High Court has, and I'd like to repeat this once again, put a stop on all caste-based rallies. But why do caste-based rallies happen? Caste-based rallies happen because political leaders use caste to mobilize vote banks, and they do it openly. Therefore, my first question is to the Congress representative Abhishek Manu Singhvi, by the way, welcoming Prakash Javadekar after a long time, national spokesperson of the BJP, Dalit activist Kancha Ilaiya, Sankarshan Thakur of the Telegraph, and representing the Samajwadi Party this evening is Naresh Agarwal, Member of Parliament. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Abhishek Manu Singhvi, I will give you one example of the Congress Party's hypocrisy to start with. The Congress Party says, let's talk about Rahul Gandhi, for example. Rahul Gandhi says in July, Andhra Pradesh was behind us, look where it is today. In Uttar Pradesh, people don't talk about the state, they talk about their caste. Same Rahul Gandhi, in December that year, addresses a packed MBC rally in Ramabai Nagar in Uttar Pradesh. And you know what he says there, Abhishek Manu Singhvi? He says the cell phones in their hands were powered by a policy promoted by Rajiv Gandhi, but authored by a man who was a Vishwakarma by caste. So he brings the caste factor. He addresses an OBC rally in Kanpur, addresses an MBC rally in Ramabai Nagar. When he goes to Karnataka, the OBC unit of the state has a separate motorcycle rally for Rahul Gandhi. You know, this is the hypocrisy to stop which the High Court has had to intervene. Abhishek Manu Singhvi, wouldn't you agree with that? That your party too has been totally hypocritical.
Arnav, after your 1 minute long question,
yes,
let me make my points, the first of which is, the High Court judgment is certainly well-intentioned, well-meaning. It has the great nobility of thought. Unfortunately, we have that nobility also partly in our drawing rooms in urban areas. But this is not, and I'm saying it very clearly, and let me repeat, I'm not saying it as a party line, because party has not been and taken a decision on a one-day-old judgment. But I'm fairly certain that this should be the line across the board, for the Congress at least. You cannot wish away caste in the real world. It is like saying that by a magic wand, I direct you, Arnab Goswami, to do away with crime, law and order, rape, kidnapping. That is a very well, and I'm not at all doubting the motives of the High Court. But the reality of India is caste. And unless you understand the reality, you will keep on mixing up the statements you just quoted. What Rahul Gandhi, or for that matter, why Rahul Gandhi, all politicians of all political views, will say and can say, and rightly say, is that look, some of the crimes committed in the name of caste, some of the great absurdities in the name of caste, some of the terrible discriminations and oppressions in the name of caste must be eradicated. But at the same time, we have to laud the efforts of those who have been oppressed as a particular caste group,
you know,
to have come up and achieved something.
But Dr. Singhvi,
now the reality is, Arnab, just half a second more, the reality, half a second, Arnab, half a second, please. The reality is, howsoever well-intentioned, and that's the basic point I wish to make, no court judgment can wish away. It amounts to saying that, you know, this has to come by affirmative action,
no,
by evolutionary action, by legal
not
action
wish away.
Of statutory kind.
Not wish
and
away.
I say that you must
not wish,
no,
away.
Not wish away.
Not wish
not
away.
I'm saying
not,
not
no, no,
wish
no, no,
away,
no, 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 no,
directed
no,
away.
No, no, first
can't
of all,
away.
First
can't
of all,
Arnab, can't be directed away.
First
can't
of all,
can't be given a mandamus about.
First
and ultimately, you are very much in the domain of
no, 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 no. Sankarshan disagrees. Sankarshan disagrees. So do I. And let me say this: Did I note
I
a slight bit?
No, no, one minute.
Did I? Did I note
a? Completely agree with
did
what
I,
Abhishek Manu Singhvi is saying.
No, I will come to you, but I just want to say one thing to Abhishek Manu Singhvi, Sankarshan, at the start. That I sensed,
sure,
a slight patronizing tone of Dr. Singhvi right at the start when he said this is the noble thoughts, the nobility which happens in drawing rooms in urban areas. I want to remind the Right Honorable Abhishek Manu, yes, Singhvi, that it was Rahul Gandhi's slogan, and this is the slogan: Jaat pe na baat pe, Rahul ji ki baat pe, बटन दबेगा हाथ पे. इन अदर वर्ड्स पीपल विल वोट फॉर राहुल्स प्रोमिसेस नॉट ऑन कास्ट लाइन्स. यू सेड दिस बिफोर द यूपी इलेक्शंस. And I say today that it is not about the reality of this country. Abhishek Singhvi, 1 minute. When you have Kshatriya Asmita Sammelans, when you have MBC rallies, when you have OBC rallies, when you perpetuate caste, then you cannot accuse people of caste being a reality. It is political parties
who have
perpetuated caste in this country.
Tell me today if there is one more. Okay, let me ask you reality. I'm not saying it's good or bad. Tell me today what is the most unifying factor in the country, in India, more than language, more than color, more than religion. Unfortunately or fortunately, it is caste. Can you ignore it?
Can you deny it? Can you deny it that in Raebareli? I'm sorry.
No.
Can you deny that in Raebareli? Rahul Gandhi said people will reject those parties which play the politics of caste. And the same party organizes Kshatriya rallies and MBC rallies. That's hypocrisy. Sankarshan wanted to take you on. Sankarshan, your response to
what
Abhishek Manu Singhvi.
Said is that the
Sankarshan's response, please.
Arnab, I will. One, I substantively agree with what Abhishek Manu Singhvi is saying. Two, I will go beyond this. I think I see this ruling as fundamentally undemocratic. India is a coalition of many kinds of identities. And you cannot stop congregations of various kinds of identities unless there are ultra-wires, unless they are, you know, preaching hate, preaching, fanning hatred towards other communities. You know, you cannot stop groups of people, whether they are women, men, caste groups, you know, lobby groups of, various kinds of interests from congregating for a particular purpose. This is fundamentally undemocratic.
Then,
unless they are violating
why does your party say there should be no caste politics?
It is for them to answer that.
You two play caste politics. And by the way, I'm getting a few calls saying, where is the BSP representative on the news hour tonight? For all the viewers, we asked the BSP, they didn't come. Prakash Javadekar, why is your party also being as hypocritical as the Congress on this issue?
Your question is over?
Yes, short question to you. Why is your party being as hypocritical?
Yeah. Now, let me tell you the first. We will like every time that ideology and issues should become the decisive factor in any election. And there are two realities about caste. Caste is a reality. In Hindi we say jati kabhi jo jati nahi, the caste which doesn't go.
It's terrible that you say that on a national channel. I think that's a regressive point of view.
One minute.
And I don't think identities are based on caste.
It is not my saying. 1 minute. I am not saying
it is my
opinion.
They are based on caste. No, it's a constitutionally valid identity.
1 minute. I am saying one thing, that the real experience is before partition or before independence, what we were observing about caste was that caste was observed in day-to-day life, untouchability and marriage. That untouchability, very fortunately, has gone. So daily life, there is no caste. But in marriage, it is still there. And unfortunately, it has cropped up in politics, political behavior of the voter.
It is not
to an extent.
It is, politicians have used
that
caste.
That is not a good thing.
Politicians have used caste. And
no,
I'll tell
no,
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 no politicians
let me complete,
have.
Let me complete. Let me complete. Let me complete one sentence. So I first welcome the decision of the High Court.
Yes.
Because caste rallies is a very unfortunate part of democracy to where we have come to, and so that should be immediately stopped.
What is unfortunate? No, 1 minute. I want to ask you in detail. 1 second, sir. What is unfortunate? 1 second. I want you to tell me today, why do you think caste rallies are an unfortunate thing? Tell me, please, Prakash Javadekar.
Because appealing on caste and not on issues and ideology is not good. But unfortunately, the fact is that certain sections of society, certain sections, not all sections in all castes, but certain voters definitely do not cast their vote, they vote their caste. And that is a reality which prompts people to do this, but that should be avoided, and that should, if High Court order actually is implemented, I'll be more than happy.
Now here's the question to you. There is such complete hypocrisy and contradiction in the initial observations of our political panelists that I'm completely stunned. I want to tell you that caste has been used to mobilize people. And, you know, for example, let me give you one example. Your party leader, Murali Manohar Joshi, was part of a seven-hour-long, well-attended Vipra Mahakumbh, Grand Congregation of Brahmins. 1 minute. Grand Congregation of Brahmins. This happened in December 2013. Your party has organized the biggest Dalit rallies 1 month back. Okay, and don't force me to tell you what Sushil Kumar Modi did in 10th April 2012, because I will say it today, and then I want to ask you whether people are casteist and hence you are making them the identities, or whether you're forcing these identities on the people. Because Sushil Kumar Modi said in April 2011, ahead of the election to 11 seats of the Legislative Council, the BJP organized a state-level conference of the delegates of the Tanti, Tatwa and Patwa caste groups at the Abhyanta Bhavan in the state capital. And the person who attended this addressed the meeting was Sushil Kumar Modi. He said separately that the number of each of the 120-odd extremely backward castes is not big, but now you must unite yourself and make a solid, unassailable body. And then he went on to describe how Tanti, Tatwa and Patwas should come together. Are you telling me, Prakash Javadekar, that your political party is not exploiting caste? You are exploiting it, you are using it. Just as the Congress is and the SP is.
No, but you want...
I've given you three examples.
You want this to continue or to end?
I want it to end.
Again, that is what we are here.
Really?
That is why I am saying that I welcome the decision, and this will definitely help to an extent. This is one step. But let us also understand that from my, that was Jai Prakash Narayan's appeal. That was Deen Dayal Upadhyay's appeal. And that appeal was from mindset, you have to decast, and then only you can think about ideology.
Well, I think
you can think about issues.
I think it's all
the nation, and then your voting behavior.
There are certain voters
who vote on ideology. There are certain voters who vote on issues. And there are certain voter section that they vote on caste.
I'm sorry. Don't blame the voter. It is political parties who are encouraging them to vote on caste. And my question, by the way, they are, because I know Madhusudan Mistry, I am told, and Abhishek Manu Singhvi will know this, Madhusudan Mistry has asked for a breakup of various castes in all the 543 Lok Sabha constituencies in preparation for the general election. They want population figures, but along with that, they want all the full caste breakup, along with the caste details of the sitting candidates, the aspirants, and then make a caste analysis. So, you know, who is putting this in stone? It's the political parties. But Kancha Elaya, you're also for it, I presume. 65 years after independence, I'm sure that you are also for it. What is your view on what the Allahabad High Court has said today, right or wrong?
No, Arunab, I don't understand how a court can say that there cannot be caste rallies. Now, for example, there are untouchables who are being oppressed every day in villages. And these untouchables come as a caste and say in the street that please don't treat us as untouchables. Will the court put them behind bars?
Absolutely.
And will the court put Ambedkar for organizing scheduled caste federation and create a whole system of rights for the people? Now, it's not just a question of political parties addressing today.
Mr. Elaya, I want to ask you, there are 18 crore Indians, I am told between 15 and 18 crore Indians, who will be first time voters in the general elections of 2014. What you are saying today is all these Indians should make caste the number one issue. and this country in 2013, 21st century India should be defined by Kshatriya rallies and Brahmin rallies and Dalit rallies. You know, this is what you want the identity of India to be known by. I'll open up the phone lines in some time. I'm coming to you, Abhishek Manu Singhvi. Respond.
Arunabh, the question is, court is not just talking about caste and oath.